I got. Okay, we're on the air. This meeting of the Rolling Meadows City Council is hereby called to order. Let's do the Pledge of Allegiance. Please stand.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, thank you. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Cannon?
Here.
Prina?
Here.
Majikis?
Here.
Judd?
Here.
Baner?
Here.
Deestis is absent. Veenbos?
Here. And Mr. Deestis is just out of town for the week, so it's not a health issue. He's just out of town on business travel. So we have six present and one absent. There's a quorum. Therefore, members of the audience are reminded that these proceedings are being videotaped for current and future broadcast over the city's cable television channel. And the first order of business is an incredible good one. And I'd like to have a motion to approve the minutes of December 13th council meeting and the December 20th committee of the whole meeting as well. Can I have a...
So moved.
Mr. Prina, seconded. Thank you very much. And again, this order is to approve the minutes from December 13th and the 20th. And we have a motion that has been seconded. Are there any corrections or deletions to either set of minutes? Seeing none, the question is, shall both sets of minutes be approved? All those in favor say aye.
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 Those opposed say nay. The ayes have it, and both sets of minutes are approved this evening. Now let's get to the best part of the agenda, and that is a motion to deviate, to talk about something very, very good. Do I have there's a request to deviate from the agenda for two purposes tonight. The first one is the Community Policing Award for Joe Pistorius, and number two, Harvest Bible Recognition of Police Food Drive. Is there a motion to deviate from the agenda for these two purposes?
So moved.
Mr. Banger approves. And there has been a second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, say nay. The ayes have it, and we will now move to deviate from the agenda. At this point, I'd like to have the chief please come and present the award to Officer Pistorius. And I'm going to use the Tom Rooney traveling microphone.
Is that good? Come on up here, Joe. Everybody could hear me. Do I need the microphone? You guys hear me?
Is that good?
No, you do.
That's better.
For the recording.
Here we go.
You gotta make this official.
So, you know, we talk about the police in Rolling Meadows, and we, you know, it goes along with all the police. We say to serve and protect. So not only do we protect, but we serve, and boy, did we serve, and we want to celebrate that tonight. So I'm going to give the microphone over to our chief, who's going to present an award. And all I can say from the bottom of my heart and from all the council, Mayor of the City of Rolling Meadows, incredible job. We're so proud of you guys.
Thank you, Mayor. If you guys just give me a moment, I want to read this award that we're giving Officer Pistorius. As Chief of Police, it is my honor to present you the Community Policing Award. During your duty day, without being assigned or directed, you took it upon yourself to visit the local food pantry, which was located a short distance nearby to check on them and promote our community policing efforts. To your surprise, you noticed the shelves bare. Volunteer staff on scene confirmed supplies were low this holiday season. Upon your departure, you realized something needed to be done. And, you know, I'm just going to deviate for 1 second. Joe, he's a very tall individual, but he does not get all his strength from his height. I'll tell you, he gets it from the size of his heart. He is one of the kindest, most compassionate individuals I had an honor to work with, so thank you for that. Like I said, he determined that he would take action. Something needed to be done regarding the food pantry. You did not feel or believe in your heart that it was someone else's problem. You left that location with an idea. A Fill the Humvee campaign was organized, scheduled, and promoted because of your dedication and effort. In one single afternoon, with the assistance of many volunteers which are here today, we not only filled one Humvee on December 10th, we filled 8 additional police vehicles with food for the food pantry. My understanding is that like 85 families benefited from your actions, so thank you very much for that. So Officer Joe Pistorius' actions warrant issue of the complete Community Policing Award as he recognized and addressed a significant problem. He was the catalyst for the community to jump into action and donate such a large quantity of supplies at a time when needed most. So thank you.
Thank you.
And he doesn't just get the plaque, he also gets a ribbon for his uniform. So thank you all.
That is an incredible statement. And I also want to just do a shout out and reach out to Jewel Food Store that also was a part of this and helped participate. So although they're not here, to my knowledge, they just helped out. You know, let the squad cars park out in front one after another. How many total squads do we have?
We had one Humvee and 8 squad cars filled with food items.
Can you imagine? And all we wanted really was to get one Humvee to get it going.
Well, we filled that Humvee within an hour. I was out there. And like I said, I just want to thank the community, too. You know, they were coming out with shopping carts thinking that they were just going to give like one item out of the cart for the Humvee. And they're like, no, Chief, the whole cart's for the food pantry. So it was very heartwarming to see that.
Incredible. And what better time, Thanksgiving, Christmas, for people that are in need. And at the end of the day, it tells a lot about the residents, the citizens in Rolling Meadows, how they give. So incredible by everybody, those that are watching on television. Incredible job by all of you, and I'm proud of all of you. Thank you. So we're gonna segue, if that's the correct, to Harvest Bible, who is a major part of this as well, and they would like to have a little bit of time to talk to us about the same event, incredible event.
Thank you, Mayor Beanboss. Thank you, honored council members, chiefs, police officers. On behalf of Pastor James McDonald, our senior pastor and the elder board of Harvest Bible Chapel, it's an honor for me to present to Chief Nowacki and the police department here at Rolling Meadows an honor in recognition of what you've done to serve sacrificially through compassion the families of our community. September of 1988, Harvest Bible Chapel launched here in high school, the High School of Rolling Meadows. Since then, it's turned into a worldwide movement. 155 churches, churches in Nepal, churches in Liberia, churches in Romania and throughout Europe and the North America filled this movement. And we have 7 campuses in our local area in the city. Well, Rolling Meadows is the hub of all that activity. And we've always sought to be a source of good for this community. And I see it while there are unparalleled coalitions of evil in this world conspiring against what is good and right and what we know to be healthy and right for people. I'm glad that there's a new coalition for good in this community. And I take great pride and joy in Chief Nowacki and his efforts and all of the officers that gave of their time and invested personally, sacrificially, for this investment in good. And it's because of that, it is our privilege as the leadership of Harvest Bible Chapel to present to Chief Nowacki and this entire police department this honor, recognition of your sacrifice and good. Partnership for Good, Chief Nowacki. Thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
Thank you, and thank you all for the work. Joe, incredible again. And we should have this as almost put up over by the police department so everybody can see it, because you guys, it's not just about earning it. It's just like, this is just an incredible thing that people do, and it was just inspiring for me. And by the way, I was at the ribbon cutting ceremony for Jewel. They had kind of like a reopening. I'm not sure if everybody knows that, but I happened to be there for it. And there were shout outs to 2 groups, and it was our chief, fire chief, and his group, as well as the police. I know the fire group also had a little bit to do with this too, so we want to thank them too. But incredible job, and thank you all for being here tonight. Okay, thanks. Okay, that brings the council back to its original agenda, and we'll start off with the mayor's report. And outside of an incredible night celebrating this, I just wanted to also thank the Rolling Meadows Museum that had their open house on Sunday, and many of us showed up to to visit, and it was an extremely cold day, but it was very warm with the volunteers that are there. So one of the things that I did notice when I was there, they're always in need of more volunteers, and if anyone's willing to help that group, they're also the Heart and Soul of Rolling Meadows, and I would appreciate if anyone would step forward and help them out. And that takes care of my mayor's report for this evening. Are there any ward reports? Mr. Perena.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I did have the honor of attending again the Historical Society. That what is really interesting is the generosity of not only being there, but as you walk out the door, if you didn't take like at least a bag full of cookies, you were you didn't want to hurt anybody's feelings. I took them home, but Alderman Banjer ate them there. Sure. So we just, so that worked out well. I do want to some kudos. I just came from a meeting on. I was in Arlington Heights before I came here, and came through Gateway Park. And Mr. Cannon was the gentleman who was foremost in pushing us for getting new signs. And I saw them; they were lit up. They looked really great. So, Mr. Cannon, I think you should have a little pat on the back for that, because it really brightened up that corner and sort of gave us a new image. So, thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Any other ward reports this evening? Okay, let's move forward next to the opening the meeting up to the public for 20 minutes. And we do this evening have 5 signatures of people that would like to come forward and talk. And with that in mind, with the 5 people that are coming forward, we will have the council will allow that group to have 20 minutes to address the City Council on matters that are on the agenda or regarding other issues. And we ask that the persons that are coming forward to the lectern, that to the City Council, keep their comments to 5 minutes in length. And the comments must be addressed to the council as a whole through the mayor, and profanity may not be used in any form. So the first person on the list is Steve Hollish. Mr. Hollish, would you like to come, please?
Good evening.
Thank you.
I guess the only thing that I would want to bring up is I have a few items. I'll try and keep it as short as possible. But the first item, which is probably a subject that everybody likes to go into, and that's the relocation of the fire stations. Last year, Committee of the Whole, I heard a commitment that said January 10th, you're going to make a decision whether you're going forward or not. Now, I don't know if anybody's on the sign-in from that group, from the program group that's in charge of that, but I don't see it. I would expect you're all going to make some sort of decision tonight going forward on this. One of the things that I see is there's always been talk about the favorite sites. Now, I don't know where the sites are going to be. I went back through a lot of the documentation that I have, and there were 2 sites, one off of Hicks and just south of Euclid, and then New Wilkie and Central. New Wilkie and Central, I think, is gone because I think that property has been bought out. But what I envision seeing is, why not try and use the property that we have? There's property right across the street that could be used for Station 15. If you're doing a like for a like, you build 15 the same way. Now, 15 is on about 28,000 square feet. That property is 52,000 square feet. So in my mind, there's no reason why you couldn't put 15 over there. If you want to move 16, move 16 south, and I would say move 16 to the old Public Works building. That's 69,000 square feet of property. It's centrally located down south. Makes it great to accommodate all the calls down south, and it doesn't cost us anything. So we're saving money on real estate, and going forward, you can get them all started. Make the idea to start building as soon as possible. And one of the things that I saw, being a program manager from what I used to do, I can't believe how long this is taking. I mean, I built a whole cellular system in Arizona in 37 weeks. You guys are spending years at trying to decide what to do. It's not a big deal. You're going to move 2 stations, get it done. You've got money, let's go forward and get it done. You want to get the response times better, make it a national average better, This is a win situation to move the stations to property we've got, go forward. The only thing I would have to say is that you're not going to build two stations identical, because I don't think you could fit two identical stations on the property that we have. One would have to be a like 15, same size, same kind of capabilities, and the other one could be 16, which is on the bigger piece of property. So that's one thing I've got to say. The other thing I was going to go into is the bike path that's proposed. I think it was proposed. I don't know if it was voted on. I don't understand how that piece of property could cost so much money for such a small bike path. I don't know what bike paths typically run, but that amount of money for one little piece has got to be astronomically. I can't believe that the state is saying, what are we paying for, being that it's that small a piece. But anyway, if that goes through, it's a good idea. It's just, I'd like to see why it costs so much. And I don't have that information. And hopefully I'm not run on 1 minute. The other one, the HVAC here in the council, or not council, City Hall, it's looked like it's going to be redone. You got to come up with a better procedure for bidding. To come back with only one person bidding on a project this large doesn't seem right. There should be more people out there that could get competitive bidding and go forward and get a better price. And then the last thing, and I'll make this one real short, is the Dominic's property. You're all aware they put fences up. They're planning to do something. I say let them do something. We stay out of it. Let them develop it or do whatever they have to do. But Rolling Meadows should not get into any involvement of that property at all. That's it. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Hollish. Mr. Ruff?
Thank you. Good evening. I'm David Ruff. I'm here representing the library regarding item A, which is a special use permit for our expansion. And just wanted to let you know I'm here if you have any questions when you get to that item. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Mr. Hill?
Good evening. As you all probably know by now, my name is Jerry Hill. I come before you today as a resident, but full disclosure compels me to tell you that I will be running for the Ward 2 aldermanic seat in April. My background is in accounting and finance. A significant portion of my professional career is involved in business and financial planning, including the determination of cost effectiveness for competing capital and operational projects. My comments today relate to the fire station issue. I first spoke to you on this matter over 2.5 years ago, so I'm not quite late to the party. The observations and conclusions that I offer today are based on data obtained from the 2012 consultant report, the fire department's 2015 annual report, and its 2016 third quarter report, as well as two face-to-face discussions with the fire chief, the most recent lasting nearly 2 hours last Friday, for which I thank the chief for his gracious use of time. Later this evening, you will discuss the fire station relocation. And now is the proper time to begin that process. Because based on the data, there seems to me anyway, little doubt that a fire station is likely required in this, to serve the southern section of the city. And let's recall the impetus behind this entire discussion was to resolve a deficiency in fire call response times. And the data show the deficiency was, and still is, in the southern sections of the city. However, this issue is always discussed as building two new stations. The second, a relocation of the current, fully functional, relatively new Station 16, less than a mile east, or to be moved less than a mile east of its current location. The proposal, your proposal, assumes these two relocations are inextricably linked. I believe the rationale given is the creation of a perceived exposed area as to the far northeast section of the city with the movement of current Station 15. However, my observation, based on the data, available options, and the cost effectiveness of this second relocation, does not yet support your premise. Let's consider three major points that challenge this premise. First, travel time. Tonight, your challenge is to not replicate the very problem we are solving. For there is currently a travel time issue going south now. You must select a site for the new station that does not further impede timely travel back to the north. From a taxpayer's perspective, that responsibility is clearly on your dime. There is no data in either the 2015 annual report or the third quarter report that indicates that current Station 16 cannot get to the perceived exposed section via the direct east-west corridors of Kirchhoff Road and Euclid Avenues, absent a roughly $3 million relocation. Second, total response time. The other two of the three equally important components of total response time are dispatch processing and turnout time. Both the 2015 annual report and the 2016 third quarter report data are very clear that despite recent improvements gained by the fire chief in these areas, we still have not yet achieved the gold standard levels. Achieving those standards will produce real seconds, perhaps 30 or more, of faster response times to reach any exposed section. And dare I say, the cost to achieve those two improvements will certainly be less than $3 million. Third, there are other viable options to moving Station 16. This may be the most troubling to me. When asking the taxpayers of this city to fund a major expenditure, perhaps as large as any before it, all options have to be evaluated. It is clear that certain viable operational operations were directed to be passed over. Why is not clear. It is time to give those options consideration.
1 minute.
And if, thank you. And if they do not pass the evaluation process, so be it. But option analysis requires full vetting for all alternatives, using standard financial analytical tools and assumptions, not based on anecdotal or back-of-the-envelope calculations. I will remind you that the 2012 consultant report was very clear on two points. One, that, quote, with or without a station relocation, unquote, the city should consider a separate EMS facility. And two, that the city assess an optimal solution that considers both operational and financial parameters. Therefore, my conclusion, and it is my conclusion, based on all the data I have seen thus far, is that first, a new southern station is likely required and we should move forward. Second, you need to bifurcate this proposal and begin full analytical assessment of the available remedies before any of Station 16 transpires.
If you could just wrap it up.
This is the very last sentence. I know you had struggled with a referendum question the other day. Perhaps the referendum question should be, based on the facts presented, should Rolling Meadows relocate Station 16 at this time? Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Ostrand?
Good evening, Council. The reason why I'm here, I live near one of the stations. Most of the seniors over near Plum Grove Road and Euclid depend on that one because a long time ago, my grandfather, who's my mother's father, needed the help, and they were there on time. The one that you keep talking about more is the one down here. Okay, some people suggested, why don't you take the property on Dominic's? Or tear down the old one, build a new one. Or you would say make it in a museum and still build another one. Because you talk about education of the school kids and all that. That's what I'm looking for. And safety in other places. Another thing, one of the aldermen talked about another station in another location. I don't know what happened to that one, but two is fine if you put them in the right location. That's the way I look at it. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments. Mr. Cruz and Mr. Kilmer.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Patrick Kilmer. We have an item on tonight's agenda, 17-4-01 and 02. Just want to let you know that we're here to answer any questions you guys might have. We thank you for your time.
Thank you very much for being here this evening. And letting us know that you're here so that we can ask you any questions. With that, that's the last speakers on the list. So let's now close the floor and move to the consent ordinances. So the next item on the agenda is consent ordinances. We have two items this evening. We have an A and a B. And if any item is removed from here, there will be no consent agenda, and we'll proceed with each one individually. Does any alderman wish to remove either of these items from the consent agenda for ordinances?
B.
Mr. Judd, and which one?
B.
Okay, B then. So moving forward with A, Ordinance A is an amendment to the special use to allow additions of the Rolling Meadows Library at 3110 Martin Lane, R1 District. David Ruff is the petitioner, and this again is in for the first reading. This ordinance would amend an existing special use for the Rolling Meadows Library located at 3110 Martin Lane in an R1 Residence District. The petitioner wishes to add a total of approximately 2,700 square feet onto the library in two separate projects. Project one includes the construction of 1625 square feet addition in the southwest corner facility to accommodate two small meeting rooms and a flex room. Project two includes the construction of 1,075 square feet expansion of the receiving room area on the north side of the building. At the regular scheduled meeting of the Planning Commission on Tuesday, on December 6th, 2016, a public hearing was held on this matter. The Planning Commission voted unanimously to recommend in favor of the amendment for the special use to allow the expansion of this library. So with this ordinance A then, is there a motion to
move it forward?
Motion to move forward.
So moved.
Mr. Prena and seconded. Thank you. The question is, is there any discussion on this ordinance A? None. So at this point, let's just call the roll call, please.
Prena?
Yes.
Majikis?
Yes.
Judd?
Yes.
Beanger?
Yes.
Veenbos?
Yes.
Cannon?
Yes.
That's unanimous then? All six? Thank you. B, ordinance, and I'll go ahead and read that one then now too. Ordinance is to amend Appendix B, which is schedule of rates, fees, fines, and penalties pertaining to single-family housing redevelopment. This, again, is first reading. This ordinance would allow the city to rebate to the owners the amount mentioned in the ordinance, provided that a certificate of occupancy is issued on or before December 31st, 2019. So only city budgets for fiscal 2018 and 2019 would be adjusted for regarding this program. And again, the question shall be, can this ordinance be moved forward for a second reading?
Judd pulled it off.
And would you like to have some discussion on this, Mr. Judd?
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you.
I'm all in favor of this. I'd like to be a little bit more aggressive than what we have in here right now, and I'd like to make an amendment to do the such. Section 1, number F. I don't know why that's letter F, but letter F. It says commencing July 1st. I'd like to make that March 1st. And then number one, the rate's 50%. I'd like to make that 90%. And number two, it's 50, and I'd like to make it 75. I think I can do all those in one, but if I can't, then we can split them up, whatever's easiest.
Any further discussion? Is that it? I'm sorry to cut you off.
Yeah, that's it for the amendment.
Okay, well, the first one again was?
Change the date from July 1 to March 1.
Yep.
The second one is on number one, the rate is 50%, make that 90%.
Okay.
Number two, the rate is 50%, make it 75%.
Okay.
Leave the other two the same.
Okay, any further discussion on, and that's it?
Yep.
Okay, any further discussion on this, Mr. Cannon?
Thank you. I'd go along with Mr. Judd's numbers. I could accept other numbers too, but I think being more aggressive is better than less. And I'm all for getting this going as quickly as possible. All of our neighboring suburbs seem to have all kinds of great activity going on with rebuilds and new building. I'd like to see us join that party. So I'm all for that. Thank you for the amendment.
Mr. Prena?
I would just ask staff, is there any problem with going forward more aggressive. I would just like staff's input, Mr. Mayor.
Mr. Krumstock, please.
There's really no difference. The only thing that I would tell you again, we're talking about dollars, so it does change the dollars, but I guess at this point in time during first reading, we wouldn't have any reservations at that point in time. But on the flip side, could we make a motion to put this ordinance on?
Jen. Make a motion.
Okay.
Just need a motion.
Before we get to that, I needed to make sure I had a second for the previous motion to get into it. And Mr. Cannon, okay, Mr. Cannon was a second. Thank you. Okay, moving forward, any other discussion about this? And thank you, Mr. Krumstock. Mr. Prina?
Before we go forward, what I think Mr. Krumstock has alluded to is how will that affect the budget?
You know, it's all going to be one of those kind of things. It depends on how many people partake and overall. So no crystal balls in 2018 and 2019 budget, but what I would remind people, our biggest building permit amount deals with the commercials. So again, for the last few years between 2850 Gulf Road and 1701 Gulf Road and 3600 Gulf Road, those large permits have actually maintain the budget overall. So we're still talking about hundreds, potentially thousands of dollars if you round certain things on the building permits. But again, without having that crystal ball, we would be scheduling some money to go out. And again, every year when they would come in, we would be looking at those budgets.
Okay. Thank you. Any other comments? Mr. Judd.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Correct me if I'm wrong. Mr. Krumstock, though, the EAV will change on these significantly higher, which will essentially bring the money back in at a quicker rate than what
that's absolutely correct. And actually, for the residents, as the EAV increases, that will actually help on the property tax, how it's actually adjusted for everybody. So again, the higher the EAV, the more healthy a community is and actually better for us as we continue growing and developing.
Perfect. Thank you.
Okay. Any other discussion on the motion, Mr. Judd, or no? Okay. Good. Okay. With that in mind, then let's take a vote on the addendum to the motion. Then
to amend.
Okay. To amend the motion. First of all, so if you could call the roll on that.
Someone needs to make the motion.
I need a motion. Thank you, Mr. Yeah. Judd. Mr. Judd's got the motion. Second? Mr. Cannon? Okay, we're good. Let's call for a vote then.
Majikis?
Yes.
Judd?
Yes.
Banjer?
Yes.
Veenbos?
Yes.
Cannon?
Yes.
Prina?
Yes.
Okay. Unanimous. 6-6. So we made an addendum to the motion now. So now let's go back to to B then, mm-hmm. And going back to B, again, it's the ordinance to amend Appendix B, schedule of rates, fees, fines, and penalties pertaining to single-family housing redevelopment, being the first reading with the addendum that were just made. So mm-hmm. Can we move forward on a vote for that? Any discussion, further discussion on it? No? Call for a vote.
Judd?
Yes.
Banjer?
Yes.
Veenbos?
Yes.
Cannon?
Yes.
Prina?
Yes.
Majikis?
Yes.
Okay. Unanimous. Thank you. Moving on then to a new business. We're looking at C, motion to approve and ratify payment of bills of warrant 12/27/16 and approve payment of bills on warrant 110/17. This, again, has been presented by the Finance Department. Is there a motion to approve both warrants? Mr. Cannon, second. Mr. Banger. So we have a motion that has been seconded. Is there any discussion on this? Okay, seeing none, shall the warrants be approved? Clerk, please call the roll.
Banjer?
Yes.
Veenbos?
Yes.
Cannon?
Yes.
Prina?
Yes.
Majikis?
Yes.
Judd?
Yes.
All six in favor and none opposed, the warrants are approved. Moving on to consent revolution, or excuse me, resolutions, not revolutions. Might be a revolution. We'll see how this goes, right? Okay, we have D, E, F, G, H, and I this evening. So we have six items. Does any alderman wish to remove an item from the consent agenda of these resolutions? Mr. Judd.
H and I.
H and I, so that leaves us with four resolutions in one motion without debate then. Is there a motion to move forward with the four? Mr. Cannon? A second? Mr. Banger? So there's been a motion that has been seconded. The question is, shall all four of these resolutions be adopted?
Beambus?
Yes.
Cannon?
Yes.
Perina?
Yes.
Majikis?
Yes.
Judd?
Yes.
Banger?
Yes.
Okay, moving forward for H and I, we'll start with H, Resolution 17-R05, Award Contract for HVAC Engineering Construction Services. Again, this resolution, if adopted, would authorize a contract for Clark Dietz Engineering for the construction management and oversight of the work to be completed on the contract with Amber Mechanical Contractors on a modification to the City Hall and Police Station HVAC systems to remedy the existing problems.
Make a motion to approve.
I would like to make a motion to approve this. Mr. Banger, a second. Mr. Cannon. Mr. Judd, you asked that this be pulled. Would you like to make a comment?
I voted against this for the construction itself, so I'm going to vote against this as well, just to stay consistent. Thank you.
Okay. Any other discussion on this item? No? Okay, can we then, if there's no other discussion, then can we have a call for a vote then?
Cannon?
Yes.
Perina?
Yes.
Majikis?
Yes.
Judd?
No.
Banger?
Yes.
Beambus?
Yes. So five in favor, one opposed. And it passes. Aye. Resolution 17-R06, approve intergovernmental agreement with Arlington Heights for bike path costs. This resolution, if adopted, would authorize the approval of an intergovernmental agreement for phase two design engineering, phase three construction and construction engineering cost sharing with the Village of Arlington Heights for the proposed Euclid Avenue bike path project from Rawling Road to Salt Creek. Mr. Chud, you asked to have this
motion
one.
Motion to approve.
A motion to approve. Mr. Banger, second. Mr. Cannon, thank you both all night long. Mr. Chud, you've asked to have this pulled. What would you like to discuss?
Just the same issue. I've been opposed to this from day one, and nothing against the bike path itself. Just the costs, I think, are substantially higher. So okay. I won't approve this either. Thank
okay.
you.
Okay. Any other discussion on this, Mr. Cannon?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I too am opposed to this. I've been opposed all along. I just like to remind the residents between this bike path and the other small one we did near the library. I think they're nice additions. I am for bike paths. I did have a resident call me this last week saying, why are you against bike paths? I am not against them. But when we spend $1 million for less than a mile altogether, I'm troubled by that. I think there could have been a better way to get this done at a lesser cost. But I lost that battle a while ago. But I'll be voting no against it. Thank you.
Okay. Any other comments? Okay. And if there are no other comments, then the question, shall the resolution be adopted? Will the clerk please call a roll on this one?
Marina?
Yes.
Majikis?
Yes.
Judd?
No.
Banger?
Yes.
Beambus?
Yes.
Cannon?
No.
So four in favor, two opposed. The motion passes. Resolution passes, I should say. That brings us to other business and reports. Mayor appointments, there are none this evening. No mayor proclamations either. Does the city clerk have a report this evening for
us? No, Mr. Mayor.
No city clerk report this evening. That brings us to city staff reports. Let's start with number one. Mr. Krumstock, if you could talk to us about community items and just to start with.
Thank you very much, Mayor Beambus and the city council. Obviously, on the sheet, we have seven, and I do have one more to add. Obviously, the last day to register to vote is in the April election by paper is March 7th, and if you're doing it by online registration, it's March 19th. We will be reiterating this over the next few city council meetings. Obviously, what we mentioned earlier in the city council meeting, we do want to thank everybody who donated and helped the Rolling Meadows Police Department during the December food drive that benefited the food pantry in Rolling Meadows that's located at 1051 Rolling Road behind the Molly Maids. And again, it did, it was associated with the Harvest Bible Chapel. And again, everybody who helped out with donating at the boxes here at the Park District, at the library, and then obviously Fill the Humvee, which turned into Fill One Humvee and Eight Squad Cars, was greatly appreciated, as you stated. We also want to thank everybody who donated blood at the December 20th City Blood Drive. And again, regarding holidays, as we continue on, we do, the city overall does thank Walmart and Papa Severio's for donating gift cards to the winners of the third annual Police Department Social Media Holiday House Contest campaign. This year's winners were, first place was 3708 Rywick Court, second place was 3708 Pheasant Drive, third place was 1908 Cindy Court, first runner-up was 2401 Flicker Lane, and the second runner-up was 3405 Pheasant. Pictures of the homes that actually are listed in this are actually on the Police Department Facebook. There's also some additional items on that Facebook page. Obviously, if you walked into City Hall, we have continuing going on between the City Swank and Elgin Recycling. We are conducting the Holiday Light Extension Cord and Wire Recycling Program. The collection box will be here until February 10th, 2017. And again, it is a good way for recycling lights as they break, as you change them out, or anything else that needs to be going on. Obviously, coming up next Monday, City Hall will be closed for Martin Luther King Jr. holiday on Monday, January 16th. There will be regular refuse and recycling collection on that day and throughout the week. So there are no changes in refuse for that. Obviously, the last one that we mentioned, and we did mention during, obviously, Alderman Prana and obviously Mayor Veenbos, if you haven't visited the museum, it's a good time to do it. It's still decorated for the holidays. They are located at 3100 Central Road. They are open now only on their winter hours, which are Sunday from 1 to 4 p.m. And as I said, they are decorated for the season, and it's a lot of dedicated volunteers. They're always looking for new volunteers, so that's greatly appreciated too. And if you'd like to talk to the museum, the current president is across the way from me, Public Works Director Fred Wolf. The one thing that I do want to add, that's just a FYI and an item of interest. Obviously, we mentioned about keep the wreath red. Unfortunately, this year, we did not have a successful campaign. We were about 2 days short. We had a small electrical fire attributed to some of the holiday lights in a kitchen. It was extinguished pretty quickly, but we did have to put the white light up there. And obviously, what I'm trying to say is, starting in November of 2017, as people put up their holiday lights, let's hope that the end of 2017 campaign will be positive. So with that, those are items of interest.
Thank you, Mr. Crumstock. And I might add, no one got hurt in that little fire, right?
That is correct.
Correct. Okay, thank you. Thank you for that. Let's move on with Ms. Gallagher to talk about the PO disclosures over $2,500 for December 27th, 2016 and January 10th, 2017.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. There are three purchase orders for review by City Council. Nothing further to note.
Thank you very much. Lastly, but most importantly, the committee of the whole agenda, Mr. Crumstock, will defer it back to you.
Thank you very much. Obviously, on what we have for the committee of the whole meeting coming up for January is three items that we have scheduled at this plant and actually completed. The 2006 Economic Development Committee update, that's overall in economic development. We do this annually just to give you a snapshot how we ended up, how many new businesses. The other part is the sewer lateral maintenance. We haven't had this discussion in some time, but it's good for people to understand what the city actually maintains, what a resident needs to maintain, and have that overall discussion about the lateral maintenance program. And then, obviously, Old Plum Grove Road, Woodlands, that is a sewer discussion too, but we need to have that one at this point in time. February, we should have some other items in there, and there's a potential for a closed session on this night too. But at this point in time, we have three that are planned and finished.
Okay. Thank you very much. Looks like it could be a busy night then. Thank you. Moving on, matters not on the agenda. Are there any matters that are not on the agenda this evening? Would any alderman like to bring anything up? Mr. Prana.
Just to follow up to the consent ordinance B, if by the next meeting, staff would just give us a quick report. We're being aggressive in moving the dates up, what the revenue loss would be to the budget. Just a guesstimate.
Yeah, it's not going to be a change in the 2017 budget. It would be the 2018-2019 if we had any revenue changes.
Okay.
Will that give you enough time to see what the effect is, Mr. Crumstock?
Sure, it's going to be that potential.
Okay. I know. Okay, thank you. Any other items that are not on the agenda that any alderman would like to bring up? Okay, guess not. Okay, this evening there's a request to go into closed session this evening, and the purpose of this is to talk about a land acquisition which falls under 5 ILCS 120/2C5. So, the Illinois Open Meetings Act. This requires a motion and a roll call vote. Is there a motion to go into closed session this evening for the above purpose? Mr. Banger, motion, has made the motion, seconded. Mr. Cannon, again, thank you, boys, tonight. Is there any discussion? There's seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Majikis?
Yes.
Judd?
Yes.
Banger?
Yes.
Veenbos?
Yes.
Cannon?
Yes.
Prina?
Yes.
Okay, there are 6 in favor and none opposed. The council will now enter closed session. The press and audience are advised that the council does not plan on taking any action upon returning to open session. Thank you very much. We adjourn.